Those were the days when color were only naked to true eyes, yet never on TV or visuals that could emancipate people's emotions. But thanks to technology and so much research, colors have been brought to us, to our lives. So a common thought at this point must be, why is this person showing about colors? It does not make any sense. We used to do this in our kindergarten till second grade. Actually, it makes all the sense in the world now. Color theory has not developed as an explanation of how and why the effects of colors take place, as colors have always been defined in the form of abstract, where the colors mediums were ink, paint, oil, watercolors, computer display, or theater, which was never considered relevant. Color reveals information about your personality, theme, purpose you have chosen for this lifetime, the kind of partner best suits you. As we go through the journey of colors, we shall investigate the effects of relative contrasting color. But there are some parts that need to be enlightened, that color does not simply stand on its own, it has a family. A factoid discovered recently suggests that we can see about 1,000 levels of lightness and darkness. This means that the total number of colors that we can see is about 100,000. That's even better than a high LCD resolution. But the best answer to all this is, well, infinite. Color vision proposes that color information that is transmitted out of our eye by three channels, each constructed from a raw output of the eyes, which we call retina. A red-green channel, a blue-yellow channel, and a black-white channel, also known as luminance channel. Where the theory has been supported by neurobiology and accounts for the colors, experience that we all do. Specifically, it explains why we cannot perceive a reddish green or yellowish blue unless we have some technical issues with our eyes. But the point is, what are colors to you?
I would go with pink because pink makes me more happy. It's a girlish color and I just love pink.
My color would be black. I don't know, it just has this appeal with me. It's been there for a really, really long time. Like, no matter what I do, I need to have a bit of black everywhere.
I know it is a very dark and negative color, but I think black dominates different colors because it doesn't have any shades. It doesn't have any, you can tones, it's just black and it's valid.
For me, black is a color and I just love wearing it. It gives me energy and I feel really good wearing black color. I don't know why, but it's just like, you know, it gives me that energy, it gives me that look.
That's why we are going to be meeting someone from the world of art who can tell us their story of colors. What made them become so enchanted by the domination of it.
जहाँ तक रंगों का ताल्लुक है वो तो हम जब आँख खोलते हैं तो without that we have everywhere these colors and I was very much like मैं एक आम सी बात कहूँगी कि बचपन से ही वो चीज़ थी definitely वो हर artist मेरे ख्याल एक होता है कि उसके अंदर शुरू से एक चीज़ होती है जो वो रंगों को पहचानना motifs को elements को designs को पहचानना वो शुरू से शुरू कर देता है so that was into me although I wanted my parents want me to be a doctor बट डी से डॉक्टर तो ना बनी, डी से डिजाइनर जरूर बनी.
इंडीड.
बट रंग जो है वो डेफिनेटली जब कॉलेज में एनसीए में गए तो तब सही मानों में जो स्टडीज हुई उसमें पता चला कि रंग का असल मकसद क्या है. हम ऐसे ही रंग नहीं पहन सकते, हम ऐसे ही रंगों का इस्तेमाल नहीं कर सकते. देर आर कलर्स जो कौसिक एजाम के जिसको आप रंग कहते हैं वो सारे हमारे पास इर्द गिर्द होते हैं हमारे, बस उनको हमें सही तरह से इस्तेमाल करना है. लाइक वी वर्क फॉर द बेस्ट. बेस्ट में आप हर 3 मंथ्स के बाद उनकी कलर पैलेट चेंज होती है. इन पाकिस्तान नो. हम गर्मियों में भी यू मस्ट सी दिस इज जून इज कमिंग आई एम वेयरिंग ब्लैक बट इट्स वेरी रियली रिडिकुलस. और आप नोट करो कि बहुत ज़्यादा लोग ब्लैक को यहाँ पे पहनते हैं बट हमारे सर्कमस्टेंसेस आर डिफरेंट रिगार्डिंग कलर्स. सो कलर इज मीन टू मी अलॉट. लेकिन आर्टिस्ट सभी पढ़ते हुए जब हम कलर भी बनाते हैं और कलर पैलेट पढ़ते हैं कि ब्लैक कलर जो है वो इसका ऑब्जॉर्बेंट ऑफ ऑल द कलर्स एंड वाइट इज द कलर इज टोटली नियॉन बिल्कुल इसका ऑपोजिट होता है. तो आई लव ब्लैक इज वेरी मच एंड ऑल द लाइक बेसिकली द ब्लू टोन्स ऑल्सो. मुझे ब्लू की टोन्स बहुत पसंद है बिकॉज ग्रेजुअली जब मैं आई स्टार्टेड माई वर्क विद इस्लामिक आर्ट एंड इस्लामिक कैलीग्राफी इस्लामिक पॉट्री हमारी हाला की जो पॉट्री है उसके कलर्स विच आर रियली कूल. और अगर आप देखो तो आसमान इज ऑल्सो ब्लू. तो मुझे लगता है कि नीला रंग जो है वो बहुत फ्रेशनेस और बहुत ब्राइटनेस की अलामत होती है.
As they say, where true passion meet colors, there's nothing more beautiful than that. Are colors a part of symbolism? Of course they are. It's been around for centuries. Color symbolism is an art that refers to the use of color as symbols in various cultures. There is a great diversity in the use of colors and their association between cultures and even within the same culture in different time periods. In fact, the same color may have a different association with the same culture at any time. To prove that, colors do symbolize, like if we look at this pie chart made by David McCandles that show colors in cultures denoting a diversity of life. Let's pick a region that has the most numbers of human beings. The word that comes to my mind, you guessed it right, it's China. So let's go back to the diagram and let's see which is the most appropriate option among the list. The most suited for China is fertility, and it's red, whereas red is often used in some countries for stop signs or danger. Same as our country, where the brides wear red dresses. Ironic, isn't it? At the same time, red is also frequently used in association with romance, like Valentine's Day. It simply means that no matter what you buy or do, color can make you feel gloomy, where they can make you feel totally the opposite person. At times, it has been seen at the shopping malls that people may forgo a brand quality over color. Well, to believe it or not, there are facts that prove color has domination by its visuals, appearance over the quality. We can shut our eyes but cannot be ignorant to the fact that colors are the elements that bring everything to life, from a beautiful flower to a divine sunset, from a veracity of life to our dreams. And anything can be an eye candy as long as they have colors. In the end, colors fulfill the definition of everything.